locked in. I guess we can keep it open until they're done trading with the tiniest of possibilities that you can flex Darius to jungle because they fight. And here comes Darius jungle.
Let's see what he can get done here. Already getting the flash out of the enemy support, and this should be a kill. He very, very low on the HP, and with the bleed coming out, there's no way he stays alive, and they make sure they give the kill over to Neo.
Neo, if they can get anything out of FBI here. He has flash and cleanse.
Yeah, he's got both summoners, so should be able to get out of this. There you go. Flash is out, cleanse is away, but he's pulled right back in. Both summoner spells used and a kill still acquired, but now backup has arrived. 100 Thieves looking for the kill on the enemy AD carry, and they found it, but now we're in a 3v3. Half remove about to die back, but the wind will not become lightning in time. Abadage trying to get himself away here, but a lot of damage coming down. Two kills over onto the side.
Oh! Some of this jungle pressure off of it. Beat up the bubble lance.
Nicely done. Let's see if they can set up the rest of the kill here. Should be no problem. Closer taken very low, and Dardock just dunks him. Let's see it.
Popping your head off, as well as getting yoinked in by the apprehend immediately after. That sets up Dragon for Dignitas. Really, really good job trying to snowball this ahead.
Half HP right now and have to decide whether or not they want to go in to try to fight this. Dardock eating the second part of the wind becomes lightning. There's your bubble. Doesn't look like it's going their way so far, though, until Closer goes too far in. He's going to be killed immediately. Someday's able to swoop in, grab a return kill on the enemy jungler now, as Aphromoo tries to provide the CC while the rest of the team shows up. Someday continues to lead the charge, as Huhi tries to find a little bit more CC, and they continue the chase. 100 Thieves looking for the last little bit of damage they're going to need onto the AD carry, onto the support. FBI without enough mana to find the artillery here one more time. Neo gets away. Huhi continues zoning.
A little bit of extra damage, but, Someday here going to have a difficult time dissuading them from finishing this objective, and Dignitas get to roll their early game plan ahead quite effectively.
Dragon count here should be fine. As long as nobody gets caught here in the top side jungle, they'll just trade that. Mm-hmm. Now, Huhi's stepping forward. However, he's going to find two enemy players instead of just one. Someday's jumping in now, looking to keep the fight going. Holy moly, look at the damage! Someday already grabbing one, making two. Double kill over to Gwen as Fake God tries to get away. You've got the chase continuing here on the left, as well as Saligo's going to get hunted down by the Living Artillery. A little bit more damage coming in there, and Dignitas just got caught, man. Nearby as well. Remember, Kobe, it only takes one fight where you don't properly focus Darius for him to go to Reset City, and that is
back in on this one. You see Dardock on the front lines. Aphromoo here is ready to go.
All right, the Equalizer's been summoned up. It's going to be slain by Dardock instead, but 100 Thieves will look to take the fight. They push forward, already killing off the enemy jungler, and Someday's looking to take it even further. He'll be drowsy, but it will not matter. There's no time to get the rest of the damage after the sleep. They won't be able to chase anyone else down, so Dignitas, they do manage to steal away that Drake from 100 Thieves, but they lose their jungler as the cost.
Yeah, this Darius just keeps getting blown up here in the aftermath. You see Someday as well immediately flashing, dashing forward, trying to get as many more as they possibly can. This is going to result in 100 Thieves
again,
pushing
down.
We talked about it in the opening, but 100 Thieves sticking to their guns, sticking to their research on the meta. People are still figuring out the meta, as it is established in the LCS, and they have invested so heavily in supportive mid, carry junglers, but now they've got carries all over the map, Flowers, and those carries are fed.
Okay, Someday's going in, trying to use the invulnerability here, but a nice use of stopwatch guarantees he's not dead. The rest of Dignitas now trying to file out, but with Someday having already used his ulti, having already used that longer cooldown for the W, 100 Thieves do not want to continue the chase in what is essentially a 4v5, so they clear the wave and back away.
Yeah, Someday does have teleport.
Someday's ready to come back now. They continue to move forward. FBI is able to apply the red buff autos as Closer zones away the rest of the team. Closer might be a little bit far forward, or is he? Continuing to have the presence here from the Crescent Sweep, keeping him alive. The shield comes through. Closer with the flash over the wall to make sure he stays safe. Now they're going to force the flash out of Fake God as well, and it's 100 Thieves who are continuing to be the better team fighter.
That's the great thing about playing Xin Zhao in competitive.
To go here, can they even get here in time?
Well, they're here in time, but can they do anything about it? 100 Thieves on this bear, and that thing
is... Oh no, Dardock might just be your target here again. FBI popping the cleanse. FBI is ready to go. Fake God had to flash to get away last time, and now he's gonna die. Wind becomes lightning means Saligo is gonna be locked down as well. Double kill back over to Dogmaw, and there comes another potential kill. Dardock tried to fight Someday. Sorry, buddy, that champion was made years ago, and this one's brand new.
Meanwhile, with that Baron buff.
Nice shot. The shutdown for Neo there to at least stop a little bit of the 100 Thieves war machine.
Able to get in there for the snipe onto Someday. The W was still down for Someday after
his from applying because it looks so very close. 100 Thieves now pushing up towards this tier 2. Easily can take that one for themselves. Turret count makes sure they can win this one fast. They'll continue the push here in bottom side. We've got a four-man effort. Someday now looking to rotate down here too, just in case Dignitas look for the engage there. They use two big ulties in Equalizer and that Solar Flare. True Shot Barrage won't find anyone, and the pressure continues.
Yeah, it looks so funny every game where we have Rumble versus Karma, and late game, these Rumble ultimates go down. You see almost no damage sticking because of Karma's shield and speeds up off of those. 100 Thieves can go forward again.
Okay, 100 Thieves looking to take down the Tier 3 turret, accomplish the tower dive. Now underneath they go, looking for enough damage. They take out Dardock first. They haven't lost a single man yet. Grabbing a double kill now with Fake God finding his way into the dirt. Only Saligo and Aphromoo are left standing after FBI gets the kill on the enemy AD carry. I said they wanted to end this game fast, and they're going to do it within 60 seconds. 100 Thieves on to the Nexus turrets. First one's already down. Cannon minion is still alive. Now the Baron buff wears off, so the Cannon minion, that was actually the most well-timed Baron buff leaving ever. The Cannon minion steps up to start tanking the turret. The Nexus is under fire, and 100 Thieves, 16-6, they make it look simple.
It went from Karma, what was that?
Way out of his way to find flanks.
He will go on super, super deep stealth missions to go all the way through the back of your jungle to try and find that flank.
Impact here, this is a full commitment for EP.
It's a five-man commit, and it's a five-man potential invade. Licorice is here too. This could turn very bloody very, very quickly. Ignar's going to take most of the damage here so far. Jizuke losing against Licorice there in the 1v1. Danny having to get away with the exhaust coming out, but now with a flash up of the wall from Dreams, that's going to be a summoner spell expended. Jose De Oro, very, very low, having to get away now with a 200 HP. Johnson flashing over the wall too. So many summoner spells so very early. Impact's about to die if he ain't much more careful. Flash out to stay alive. Flash in from Licorice. Impact still alive with a knockup coming out from Ignar, who flashes back over the wall now himself. What in the world is this level one with another flash coming out now? FlyQuest, they managed to win the battle of the secure flash. The red buff, enforcing their opponents to back and then have to get to lane a little bit late. They've got a near 700 gold lead just based off of those farm advantages. Jose De Oro is here in the bottom lane. We got the 2v2 breaking out with Danny going in. Remember that they don't have the summoner spells and Dreams is down. Jose De Oro looking to swoop in now, make this go a little bit better. Ooh. Sonic Wave not hitting
them. Over jungle camp changes, never mind. Maybe we'll have some more action here. We don't have too much time for story time.
Oh, it's everywhere. The action is just happening all over the rift. Licorice trying to run away from Impact, but Impact may have been baited into the wrong spot. Licorice, a true alcove gamer, baiting his opponent in. The Haymaker comes out. Licorice nearly dies, but bop over the head with the stick, and he gets himself the second kill of the game for his team. We'll see if anything ends up happening down at the bottom side. Mid laners trading back and forth here a little bit now, and Jose De Oro will move into position to take the topside scuttle grab.
Jose, he's everything your team needs, Flower. Let the copy pasta flow.
Whoa. Whoa. Oh my goodness, Palafox looking to take down Jizuke here with the 1v1. The bomb's about to explode. They trade even here in the mid lane.
Double KO there at the exact same time.
Oh, nicely done from Jose De Oro. He has the level 6, his opponent only the level 4, but his opponent has something better. Kobe, he has a buddy.
Here on the rumble, so does not have the ulti even to try to yeet it over the wall and do something cheeky. Jose grabs the dragon there. Sonic Wave resonating escape on that one. Jose De Oro heading back up topside here yet again, as we're already going to see the fight starting off. Licorice wants to go in. He's just winning the fight all on his own. Haymaker shield's already been used. Jose De Oro going in, looking for a little bit more damage as Licorice goes forward and grabs the kill. Equalizer comes down, but a flash out will keep the Monkey King alive. Jose throws out a Sonic Wave, resonating strike right back into the fight. Sven Skaven will stand and try to fight him in single combat here. Jose De Oro underneath the turret will not have enough damage with the Dragon's Rage.
Yeah, and with that tower
he takes
on
a lot. Now Jizuke is looking for some easy pickings.
Cleanup crew's ready to go. Jose wants to get on out. Nope, it's not happening. Jizuke grabs one and he airs on the
coming in. And Palafox doesn't want anything to do with that, but Jose, he's ready to make the play here in the bottom lane with a TP coming in to help them out. Enemy TP shows up now as well, as Ignar does not get a whole lot here with the quickness, but instead he goes to sleep. The damage comes in. It's just enough. Jose De Oro goes in and gets right back out. Danny, is it?
You get these death timers pop up on your screen.
Really unlucky. Or they ping your own teleport or something, just saying, where were you? How come this guy's here and not you? Now back in the mid lane, Palafox Warlock's in some trouble with a stasis to stay alive. A very nice stopwatch ends up turning the play around.
Going up and be able to take down first turret, though, with Rift Herald on the side of EG. The Fires, this is just...
Licorice has the ulti, though. He's going to use that, trying to defend here. Rift Herald will still get the charge. It's going to be so close to dead, but not quite there. But considering the state of Licorice's health bar, they know they can't just win the 2v2 in
individualized duels, 2v3s, that we've actually seen so far.
Okay, nice sleepy trouble bubble down here onto the Tristana. Jizuke dives in there and tries to go for those critical resets. But down here in the bottom lane, let's see if this actually interrupts. Nicely done. Danny's having to run away now. He's in a 1v2. Tries to block enough of the damage here. Exhausted on the ulti. He gets about half of Johnson's HP, but Danny is now on the run. Jose de Odo going in, guaranteeing that he's going to grab the kill, and he takes it.
Opportunity,
out. Ready
baby.
To go, baby.
Lee Sin comes in, easy kick into the wall. You cannot miss that Q. It's actually impossible once you're able to get
HP, this should be an insta-kill here with just the charge. We'll see in a moment. There it is. Yup. That means another turret going over to the side
now,
of Evil G.
Approaching level 11 for the rank 2 ultimate, gets to be set up. Danny, though, is getting chunked down and teleport behind him.
Everybody's ready to go, though. There's a bunch of backup also coming in from the side of Evil Geniuses. Licorice trying to get himself back away, but he finds a 4-man knockup. He's likely to die, but likely does not mean guaranteed. Getting away with the power of the shields as Johnson moves forward with the Divine Sunderer. Jose de Odo still looking for some playmaking opportunities here. Sonic Wave down onto the enemy support. But there's enough mobility on Ignar to escape here. We're going to see
focused down by people. The flash that he had to invest, of course, you're not getting that one back in time.
Right.
Maybe we'll see if the grit, if you don't have any health to start the fight, to take damage with, so he has to recall and teleport.
But the fight's already started. They've already taken out the enemy support as Palafox looks to get away, but he's going to be shut down. They're going to find both enemy solo laners, but the objective's gone the way of FlyQuest. 3v4.
Incredibly big in making the difference between can EG actually close the distance on this range advantage. Ooh. For FlyQuest.
Nicely done from Impact there with a phase breaker to stun Licorice into his own clone. And now that he's in a 1v3, no amount of monkey business going to get you out of that one, my friend. He is gone, and Impact's getting paid. Up here in the top lane, Jose de Odo.
Bob and Weave!
For the chance to go after Jizuke here. Flashing in, has to find the Sonic Wave and the strike. We're going to pop off if they layer this AoE correctly. Johnson having to get back now at about half HP. Impact's going to find himself the target here of three different players on FlyQuest, trying to go in and find enough to really be a threat with the sleep coming through and the Haymaker going out. It's a nice stasis, able to keep Palafox alive here for a moment longer. Impact having to fall back, down to about 25% HP. Licorice now into the pit, looking for the kills on to two. He's going to find the first one with Impact out of the picture already. Jose de Odo picked off now by the enemy mid. We got ourselves a one-for-one trade, but the important part is FlyQuest jungler is down. The steal opportunity is there, but Svenskeren has no way into the pit. So instead, it is a Drake over to fight.
Between getting your bonus for your empowerment, but also keeping you away from the maximum overheat, unless you want to go for it. Here goes
okay.
Impact, though.
Impact's trying to buy enough time for the reinforcements to get here. Jose de Odo there with a Sonic Wave. Resonating Strike coming in now, looking to continue chasing the enemy top laner. Jose now down to 1/3 HP himself. Got to be careful about this one with Licorice looking to finish off the kill onto both enemy solo lanes at the same time, but he can't find either one until now. He's picking up Impact. He's behind enemy lines, but his buddies are doing a great job stopping the reinforcements from showing up in time. Svenskeren will continue marching forward here with the Flame Spitter on. A sleep onto Ignar, a kill out of Svenskeren. It's three down on the side of Evil G.
With this focus fire, really good job there by Licorice. Flash in at the end.
Turn around,
throw the bubble here. It's just going to be a FlyQuest Baron.
And this is such powerful timing as well.
Take it.
Instead, FlyQuest have the opportunity to push for the tier 2 here in the mid lane. Impact will be underneath that turret, so they know exactly where he is. Shouldn't be possible for him to get a good flank here, as the turret will fall. FlyQuest now continuing to
away.
FlyQuest just continue pushing down mid lane. Yes, they won't be able to grab the Infernal Soul here yet. True Shot Barrage interrupting the recall of the enemy jungler and giving away a single Infernal Drake ends up getting FlyQuest a mid lane inhibitor. You take that trade, my friend.
It is the Inferno Soul, but with Baron buff, they're like, yeah, okay, and anything, could you maybe set up on the Infernal Drake, try and use your poke advantage, your late game range advantage. How does this determine your setup for these objectives and the options available to each team? Regardless, though, because of the commitment, FlyQuest are able to get so much, you know, with this Baron buff, pushing through. Yes, they don't get the Infernal Soul, but Inhibitor 1 is already dead, and Inhibitor 2 going to be under attack soon.
I just found it a very respectful play from FlyQuest, saying, okay, Evil Geniuses, they're already set up around the river. They know that the gold in the game is still very close, so they don't want to just try to run in there, saying, all right, we'll just hard force it.
Any chance where they don't have complete vision.
Yeah.
They're like, the only way that you can do anything in this game is if you have better vision and you're able to sneak up. Here we go, Rumble Ultimate down.
Okay, Rumble Ulti comes in, but the Karma's doing a good job looking to keep him safe. Licorice likely to die here in the middle of everybody with a shutdown going over to Jizuke. Evil Genius. Look at the amount of grievous wounds on the side of FlyQuest. You have the Kimpunk Chainsword for the Ezreal, so 60% reduction there, as well as the Putrefier on Dreams.
Okay.
They know that they're going to stop the reset from Sabira, but now it's the engage coming out from Evil Geniuses. They've already killed Johnson, they've already killed Dreams, they've already killed the enemy mid laner as well. Palafox is gone. Double kill back over to Samira. They're going to shut him down, but it ain't happening today. Jizuke split pushing here in the top lane. It's Tristana getting it done. Jose Neoto here in a 1v2. Evil Geniuses in the enemy base. Licorice against the world to hold the Nexus.
Don't waste any time, Flowers! They find the pick!
Let's see how he does. It's Licorice going in. Ulti gonna be used. Ulti one is down. Remember, there's still the second one. This is what you were talking about, having the flash, making sure you're able to stay on top of the opponent.
Hero play?
Licorice keeping him away. Getting the flash out of Jizuke. Impact now in a 1v1 against Licorice. Jizuke working his way back up. Impact ready to have the Haymaker just about off cooldown. Licorice wants to get away, but he's caught on the very edge of that grand entrance. Still trying to fight, still trying to stand. Dreams is back alive. He'll be here to defend in time. The game will not end. The Nexus turrets will not fall. But damn, was that spicy. Nice shot from Dreams.
And they keep on firing. Impact gets chunked down.
Oh,
Baron is up.
Dreams is a little bit far forward. Jizuke, maybe
jump over.
Okay, Jose Neoto ready to try to smite fight for the Baron. Sonic Wave comes down. It's Jose Neoto stealing away the Baron for FlyQuest. Evil Genius is looking.
It will
like
mean Soul Flowers.
What an incredible turn of events. I was just talking about how hard it'll be for Samira to reset with the Grievous Wound.
They see an opening, they have to go for it. They get that engage onto this FlyQuest team. Not let FlyQuest use their range.
Okay, Impact's going in. We've already got the fight started. Licorice taking a lot of damage now, trying to spin and get away. Survives with about 10%,
again.
But no! The execution.
Inhibitor being
everybody's mid anyway.
Because also, side lane and super minions can focus on the Nexus turret on just one of them.
And build. His sixth item slot is occupied with a stopwatch on a powerful reset champion, so he might as well be. Both these teams squaring off for the Baron now. It's down to 40%. Jose Neoto here in the pit. Svenskeren on the backside here with that blast cone. Could go over the wall with it if necessary. FlyQuest doing a good job poking at Evil Geniuses before they're able to engage. Impact down to about 30% HP. The Baron's going to be secured, and FlyQuest are the ones wearing purple. Impact and Ignar both injured. The rest of Evil Geniuses still full HP. They'll march down into the bottom side river, but a teleport is showing up. We're going to cut them off. But with a teleport now being used, Evil Geniuses look to turn the tide. Svenskeren's going to be killed immediately, but he's traded back for Jose Neoto. Jizuke unstoppable. FlyQuest still looking to fight back, but it's going to be so very hard with Licorice coming back into the fight now. Bonk and Ignar over the head there with the stick. Evil Geniuses, 3v4 here on the map, trying to outplay this one, trying to outmaneuver. Danny's still full HP. He's just about ready to go. He's going in after Licorice, who uses the clone to get away there, but the ulti's still doing the damage. Wukong looking for the escape, but a Guardian Angel's going to be triggered. Johnson ready to jump over the wall if needs be, but it's going to be a very difficult situation to navigate. Evil Geniuses once again looking for the kill onto the FlyQuest top laner, but he goes in here with a Cyclone. He's going to be killed. Damage coming out with Johnson going in. Danny's about to die if he's not careful, and yes, he can't be careful enough. FlyQuest, the only enemy player left for them is Impact. They're still here with the Elder Drake. They can pick this one up very easily, and we'll see what they do after.
What an exciting exchange as they had vision of the teleport, so
they shall be rewarded indeed. Mid lane Inhibitor just evaporates in front of their eyes. Still 25 seconds on both of these incredibly critical marksmen for the side of EG. They will try to defend here against the push of FlyQuest. Sleep finds its way onto the set. He'll look to stay alive as Johnson's gonna get caught and likely killed off here, but he's still kept alive somehow by the power of the shields. There's Karma, baby! Johnson goes on a rampage!
Karma
has expired. Elder and Baron both not on the map for another 2 to 3 minutes. We'll see if FlyQuest can find anything in the absence of those buffs as Palafox just explodes, and Impact's ready to go in, looking for even more. Evil Genius is finding what could be the most important window of the game right here, right now. Grand Entrance locking down two enemy players. Licorice burning up under the power of the Flame Spitter from Svenskeren. Goes over the wall, stays alive. Electro Harpoon not hitting the target for a whole lot of damage. Sonic Wave won't find a target here. FlyQuest and Evil Genius is just continuing to dance back and forth in mid. Nobody wanting to give up the mid lane to move over towards the Baron Pit. Instead, we're going to have the Equalizer coming down, and FlyQuest trying to get away. Licorice here using ulti number one, now re-engaging with ulti two. Svenskeren popping the stasis, trying to stay alive there with that one, but he gets away now with a flash. Ignar also kicked away by Jose de Odo. Danny still looking for a chance to go in, go to Reset City.
Oh,
is he going to do it? He tries, but the flash away from Palafox just in time means no kills somehow here in this mid lane.
Give me 80 minutes of this, Flowers. We'll bring it back 80 minutes.
I've already drank three water bottles. I can't do 80 minutes of this.
Nobody.
There's no way.
Jose de Odo's at about 10% HP. This is very, very risky for the side of FlyQuest, but they're going to go in. They're going to try to fight, it looks like. Equalizer used here again. Elder Drake secured by the Evil Geniuses. Now can they make a play happen after
Not
that?
Quite yet. They only get the Wukong clone, but FlyQuest have such low HP. EG, you'd think they could just march it over to Baron too.
Yeah, if you get touched with the Elder Dragon now, you're just dead. Jose and Dreams would be dead men walking there if any stray skill shot from anyone on EG was able to land on them. EG secure the Elder Dragon here off of the big chunk, and I have to say it, Jizuke going aggressive. He chunks out Jose, forces the alert, no threat of the steal there. FlyQuest know they cannot commit to it, so they give up back-to-back end game uber objectives to the evil flash. Which allows the Wukong ultimate to really wreak devastation.
Oh, here we go. Nope, okay. It's gonna be inhibitor turret one. Inhibitor given away for free. Again, don't fight when the Elder is active. They'll march it up topside. Remember, this inhibitor turret was destroyed earlier when it looked like Evil Geniuses might have almost been able to end the game. So it's two inhibs down. Now on the side of FlyQuest, they will continue trying to defend, continue not wanting any sort of a team fight until that Elder is gone. Rumble's Equalizer, he just used it, it's three quarters of the way done. This cooldown, this ulti, is so easily usable and readily available.
15 seconds left on this Elder Dragon buff for EG. FlyQuest waiting out this timer. The clock ticking away.
There it goes again. Equalizer's coming out with Rakan going in, and Evil Geniuses looking to take the fight with the Elder. Why, they still got the chance. It's Danny looking to spin to win. FlyQuest somehow keeping everybody alive, and Evil Geniuses might get punished in time. Two kills coming out. Three kills going out. Four, five. The Nexus stays alive, and it's an ace for FlyQuest. Set timers are so long at 53 minutes, and it's up to Evil Geniuses to just watch the march all the way across the map and take the win now. What a game here between these two teams, and what a win for FlyQuest.
Take a bow. Does it end up being that?
Nope.
As they lock in the Lulu for...
And you mentioned this, instead of Karma, in the mid lane, man, those supportive mids. If you're looking
not be cognizant of it and put the ignite early, so the cleanse takes away both, but he almost never does.
Okay, so we've got Core JJ will walk up here. He'll see the Grunt potentially dying. It is a four-man dive from Cloud9 underneath the Tier 1 turret. Jenkins will be getting away for now, but they're going to turn their attention over onto Core JJ.
That wave just last hitting for perks and building it up as big as possible to crash with that cannon.
Oh boy.
And then calling all his teammates.
We're going in, though. There's no more time to talk about the last play. It's time for the new play. Jenkins getting jumped on. The wind becomes lightning, and Perks gets paid.
Perks also gets first turret. Whole first turret bonus.
Here we go. Less than two plates means goodbye, Mr. Structure. And total gold in the game. You can see Perks 500 ahead of anybody else here as Jensen gets jumped on, but now we got the counterattack from Santorin. Jensen tries to disengage, getting himself away. The bear is there, but they don't care. Perks steals the ulti and goes right underneath the tier one. Jensen barely survives, but it's a 3-0 game for Cloud9.
I think everybody who had fun flaming Perks yesterday, because it is fun to, well, we're not done.
Boy. We ain't done yet. Core JJ looking to set it up,
good
body block there from Fudge. Make sure Blabber doesn't die just yet. Blabber getting the extra heal from the second
power of the Iceborne Gauntlet. Kim Tank has been nerfed almost into the ground now. Well, pretty much, yeah, it's into the ground. Nobody really misses it. So Blabber's just making sure that he's still going to be a threat while being durable.
But this time around, much more calculated. Here we go, though. Team Liquid will make a big plan to Fudge.
Okay, Fudge getting jumped on. Santorin goes in. They will not shut down the turret there with a Volibear ulti. He's tanking it as long as he can.
Good lord! Fudge
mid very quickly before they dissolve here at 14 minutes, but Team Liquid got more in that
mid
game because it constructs your team comps like, hey, we're full dive with a Kai'Sa, okay? Everybody's getting in there. Everybody wants to get forward. One on bottom side of the map where even Tactical is arcane shifting in. Guess what? If you do that, then the counterplay of getting melee range of these champions inside, and it's very dangerous part.
Very, very dangerous, as Fudge has proven to be a danger to this bottom lane turret. That will be the third turret of the game, secured now by Cloud9. All three outer turrets down on TL's side as TL respond by taking out the
previous
top
two that we've seen today, where the teams are just bloodthirsty early on. And I feel like this is sort of what you usually can expect when you're looking at the teams that were the finalists last time around. But now Vulcan's getting himself jumped on with Core JJ going in, but the counterattack comes out. Lots of damage. The Polymorph, so incredibly powerful. And Santorin will tear Blabber apart. But now you've got Fudge going in and Perks right next to him. Team Liquid having to fall back as King falls in. They're ready to go and keep looking for more, but it's a double kill over to Kai'Sa.
They're on Tactical, and he just goes wild. Guess what? Muramana just got transformed as well. That was another one of the setups, though. Attempted flank from Perks, so watch out for that one.
This would be the third Drake of the game for C9 if they get it. Perks coming over the wall, looking to go in here with the Volley Bear. Ulti, Volley Bear number one jumping in. Santorin about to be taken down. Fudge grabbing the kill now. The fight going the way of Cloud9. Team Liquid still not done yet. They know there's some vulnerable health bars. The dragon's going the way of C9. It's King who slays it.
Tactical.
But now, over the wall comes Perks, baby! And it's Cloud9's fight for the taking. He saves the volley ulti until the last moment, and the timing is perfect.
Our Putrefire just finished on the Lulu. We'll have to see about the replay if that was finished for that fight. But you have to be a bit more patient. Meanwhile, though, Cloud9, the rewards off that last dragon fight are probably going to be too much for Team Liquid, as this is going to be
on the Dark Seal. We might see that turn into the Medjai's Soul Stealer here as Jensen steps up, but Jensen does not want anything to do with this 1v1. With him in trouble and having to back away, the rest of TL has to be ready to maybe rotate over, which gives the rest of C9 time to push onto the Tier 2. Holy cow, man. Jensen barely getting away yet again. But now that he's back to the spawn platform, that means C9 can take this Tier 2 in the mid lane.
Yes, they can.
Okay, then never mind. They're going for a pick first.
Perks gets away from the Zenith Blade, flashes to get out of the follow-up. Team Liquid still in hot pursuit. Jensen wants to continue running out now as Perks is going to get caught, trying to fight him off here with a 1v4, but he dies.
The Ocean Soul, Team Liquid, find the pick on Perks at the critical moment here, right before Dragon
hit. But now as he tries to approach, they won't even be able to see this coming. Baron goes over to Cloud9, and it's easy for that much more. 45 seconds until our next Ocean Drake in this game. Remember last time there was a pick onto Perks, but now we got the team fight breaking out. Santorin here with the stasis, keeping himself alive, but now he has to ult back out, looking to survive. Perks now using the stolen Volley Bear ulti here yet again, with Jensen having to run away using the Guardian Angel. Fudge going to be locked down. W keeping him alive, keeping him healthy. Perks using the stasis now too. Jenkins somehow also staying alive, but it's King into the back line. There's the crit, there's the crit, there's the crit. Double kill for the Kai'Sa. They're still looking to get out of there. Anybody on Team Liquid trying to survive? Perks goes forward. Core JJ is a dead man walking, and C9 will look to end this game.
As soon as Team Liquid step out from their tower defenses, Flowers, boom! Cloud9 throw the engage at them. They get the extra kills. That is going to be C9 on Nexus turrets.
C9 going in. They got those Baron-empowered minions. Red Bull Baron buff not wearing off for another 40 seconds. It is a two-man defense from the side of TL. C9 continue the pressure here as Jensen goes in looking to make a play. Santorin's going to be taken down instead. Jensen continuing to run, but the Solar Flare comes down. The Everfrost goes out. The stats get padded, and the Nexus is gone. Cloud9 take the win.
No one's really played Viego yet.
All right, well, there's Lucian. That's going to be a Blaze Olive pick in the mid lane almost assuredly. I've seen this actually quite a lot. This is a matchup that is rapidly becoming
stampy, but he doesn't actually care if you think it's meta or not. He is getting ganked.
Oh, Speaker's in here. Solo actually getting a lot of damage. And Huni going to be forced to flash away the last Q. Not there out of Solo and Speaker. Looking for the maximum punish. No flash necessary. Is that his first blood to Udyr?
A few more minutes until a play can be made here. Instead, the top lane Zard is going to continue to brawl. Speaker, though, probably interested in a revisit here. Knows there's a ward here, I believe, but he's going to go for it anyway. Now Speaker just zooming through, taps the ward once, and oh goodness, he's gone in already, but the ulti is out of Huni, and that just might be a 1v2 kill. Solo, Glyphta makes it happen, does indeed find it, and Power of Evil now here, but he runs into Iconica. Speaker, only level 5, cannot finish off Nocturne.
Awesome.
to get in fear range. Oh, he is.
Yeah, I mean, there's nothing you can do. Flash Fear's on top of you. Huni trying to get out of there. Over to the tower he goes, but the Equalizer is down. It's going to be a second kill this time. It's Iconic that nabs it.
Now, but TSM basically saying, yep, we'll split the map. Huni, you'll be fine. Try not to get too excited up there.
And want
the mid lane Herald. You don't always get the mid lane Herald here as Chime actually has found Sword Art. Good Equalizer down. Sword Art, no flash, no hope. Ablazov going to pick him off there with the ulti. Very nice.
Dragon fight will start. There is an Equalizer available.
All right, it's going to be a smite battle here. Who's going to win it? Ooh, Nocturne's shutting off the lights. What an amazing Equalizer! Triumph's going to move in there as well. And here comes Solo, TPing off to play. Golden Guardians absolutely destroying TSM in this fight. But the Shockwave from PoE is good for three bodies, but not enough kills. As Solo is finally able to take down Lost. He is ticking low, but Golden Guardians are going to win that one.
That might have been the best Equalizer of the week, period. That was so clutch from Golden Guardians. Iconic and Chime showing why the Nautilus Rumble combination is so sick. And if it was
get vision there, maybe looking to dive PoE with four people in the mid lane. Probably a good idea, but Power of Evil instead is going to have to give up the tower, which is the first tower of the game. It's still a big win for Golden Guardians.
Loss allowing him to take the turret, but you have a bounty on your head. There's no need to dive. You were there for the objective only, as you feel the hurt of that, but we got a 2v2 in store. Blazov, no face check!
No, that's not a face check. You want to see the Shockwave is going to hit two, and the Blazov a little bit too low, but Power of Evil is going to go into stasis to prevent the follow-up there from the Lucian. Very nicely done by TSM, as they're going to grab Chime out of the deal as well.
They were right there
from
just
earlier. Dragon as well might just be given up here. Oh, Speaker coming in, but doesn't quite get it. Once again, the lights are out. Committed by Golden Guardian to just keep the wave there, but TSM know they can stay around and finish that off, and indeed they will.
Yeah, it's too low for Golden Guardian in his next team fights.
I love Cloud Soul Crumbs. I don't care what anybody else thinks. I love using my ultimate. I love moving quickly.
Time you thought you had. Oh, Blood Freight in the same place?
Except this time it's Golden Guardians. Good flash from Power of Evil. Oh, Sticks, they passively in trouble. TP is coming in hot, but it's 3v2 still for the Golden Guardians. Huni just flashes in there. Now in a 1v4, incoming 1v5 with Solo moving in with the Nocturne ultimate. TSM actually reinforcing. Lost. He's found the shutdown. TSM turning the tables on Golden Guardians. Sticks, they trying to get his way out of there, but he can't do it. It's now Iconic. He's going to be locked up by Braum and Co. The stuns will come through. Orianna will claim the double kill, and TSM are going to yeet towards the Baron, but Ablaze Olive trying to keep him at bay. His Speaker.
He's in the brush. He knows what he did to Ablaze Olive earlier, and the rest of the team collapses. That fight did not
as well off the back of that. 3,000 gold ahead thereabouts, and it's about to be more on this Red Bull Baron power play, because TSM are just demolishing turrets with this Tristana.
When your main man is PoE, you can count on the rest of the team to be there to back him up, especially if he's in a control mage. So they're just going to give up the inhibitor as Solo is flip pushing off, but TSM will just back off and look for more if they can take. The top tier two is still available, but a good reset.
Off as well, Solo overstayed his welcome.
Oh no.
Oh, back he goes, trying to find a stuff to target. Sword Art, not a bad one to move to, but it's just going to delay the inevitable as Huni finally gets some revenge.
You know, the Nocturne ultimate is being much more useful, and this could be the beginning of more Viegos in the league, just as a blind top laner.
I mean, still 50 seconds left on this Baron as well. Crumbs. TSM could do so much more damage. They've already taken the mid in here. They're going to look for this top side as well. Solo back up in 2 seconds, but he doesn't have ulti. Equalizer committed to the wave to keep TSM off of the siege. But again, still time for another wave to come in. Probably two waves at least with the timing to try and siege out this tower. I don't know if Golden Guardians can defend this next inhibitor, but I think they might have to.
No Equalizer, so TSM is even less scared of this one. They can't even clump up if they want to look for something. The Shockwave is a big threat.
Yeah, you're right. With no ulti, it's not worth defending here for Golden Guardians. So you're just going to have to give it up. They will keep their Nexus for now, but even though Solo... Oh, you missed the control ward! He knows it too as he throws it.
Yeah, unhinged, would have done it. Blast cone, blind flash, but he knows if he dies there, maybe...
Here, but of course, can join quickly either by roaming through with those cloud patches that you mentioned, or just using the teleport that he has available. So TSM going
to
take
tower to defend at multiple fronts. Now, when Solo gets to defend, TSM gets to shove.
Look at Speaker, he's just constantly pressing E, looking threatening towards people. Solo's going to try and make it happen. Chime gets the front line of it. I mean, really, the UD is not that tanky. I take it back, and Stixxay almost had it, but he does get away. The Shockwave finds Solo on the other side, though, as Stixxay still peppering everyone with bullets, but Sword Art will put up the door, and Golden Guardians will be forced back. You love the attempt, but unfortunately, not enough damage to kill the UD.
Yeah, too far behind now, and because they got chunked out so hard, TSM can continue to push out. They're going to get the triple inhibitor, and Golden Guardians just cannot re-engage here. Their ultimates are down, yet they're still looking.
Yeah, Sword Art again going to block the culling.
Now Chime going to find a Pikachu once again. This time they'll find the shutdown. Huni, though, going golden is lost. He's trying to find the resets, but TSM a little low and healthy, but Iconic is going to be killed up by Lost, who flashes away now. After the hop acid flash, excuse me, as Sword Art is keeping the team alive. Huni, I don't know how you are still alive, and I don't think it's going to last too much longer. TSM with almost no help between them as Blaze only flashes in to find at least one, but how much more can they get? Power of Evil is out of mana. He's got flash. He doesn't have many teammates left either, and Lost, he's gonna try and make the big play. Oh, he got shut down by the Nocturne. His Power of Evil gonna do a touch of Alcove Gaming, but he did get a kill there with the explosive shot. The shockwave is very nice, but Sticks, they will stay alive.
But I think they're trying to bait Golden Guardians in here, not looking for a steal here for Iconic as Huni's TP'd up. They've maybe caught Solo,
but now off to the top side, Solo, is that feet gonna get caught? Power of Evil is able to find him there as he does take him out. Now, 5v4 around the Baron Pit. Golden Guardians, what can you get done here?
Clutch TP out of Huni, but now they have to 4v5 and win. There's no choice.
Time again, he's found the engage. Sword Art is gonna go golden, but now Huni gonna keep dancing around, looking for them resets. Does find one. The minions as well as now Iconic. He's gonna fall to Lost, and Lost is jumping in, having a good old time, as that is surely gonna be the Bud Light Ace for TSM as they will waltz down mid lane and take their third victory on the weekend.
They knew what they had to do. Prioritize the win. You're already so far ahead, and TSM will be our first team to end 3-0 out of the playoff squads. They look by far the best. Yeah, these games were not the optimal playoff TSM, but the record stands. They go 3-0 in week one of the LCS.
Last set of crumbs. The power of friendship is broken.
And TSM looking like real good friends.
Yeah, a lot to ask for on the side of CLG.
All right, Viego for revenge, it looks like. Yeah, it has to be. Yep, it is going to be revenge taking that champions of battle up against Gangplank. Kind of interesting
compared
one.
To the record now. 9-11. Oh, wait a minute.
Well, Turtle getting himself hooked. Raze there with the follow-up, and the Ignite is down. That's going to keep chasing him on. Raze is ready with the minigun. Turtle is dead. Raze flashes in to make sure of it. And there's the first blood. Now Raze getting excited onto Smoothie as Broxa. He's going to be forced.
You're starting bot side.
Oh,
again.
We're back at it again. It is not a replay. This is real life as Raze gets yet another kill of Destiny. How much health?
And he still has flash. They can do this again. You can call the jungler up with a flash lantern play from now on. It is over in this bottom lane for CLG. IMT is obliterating them. Maybe it doesn't stop in the bot lane, though, as Cersei's looking for a gank.
Finn, he's got flash. He's got oranges. He's going to be fine. Oh, goodness, they're getting in there. Broxa now roaming up. 2v2, 3v2 for CLG as the TP comes in. Broxa with the flash Q, but there's no sleep this time. You're not level 6, but POV is going to be enough to put the nail in Revenge's coffin.
It's
as Finn.
Them two that actually go aggressive, so they are just doing whatever they can to get them out of the lane.
Has the Kraken Slayer already finished as well for the Jinx, and IMT are overloading this side of the map. Broxa, just picked up! Straight on top of a ward! See you later, Bambi! Because Brox is going to be slain by Xerxes.
Oh, Fae on your ninth play. Like, it's all you can eat. Like, you can't criticize me for going back.
Lots of different champions can make use of this item. Obviously, Ezreal, which we see on Turtle side, will be going for that again. But Raze, 1v1ing the GP. He's gone for it. He's got the Kraken Slayer. He's dodging the barrels. Look at Raze. Get it done. Raze does get the solo, but he's failed by Finn. Raze is on record pace as he knocks down yet another tower. Luckily for CLG, no extra place to collect this time, but still.
Notice that they struggle in the late game. They've been setting up good pace.
Hook.
Oh, Destiny! The man don't miss! There's the Flay, not quite into the box, but Xerxes is there as well. Insanity has it ready to go with the Orianna in the back pocket and collects the kill as a result.
He's in your mind, CLG. He sees where you're ward hopping. Bo Belcher gets predicted.
A reset at this juncture. As Finn did take the top out of tower, that is important. They can get it just about whenever, and indeed, they deep push into a side lane. Now they can easily take mid, and IMT is full control of the map at this point. They are ahead.
CLG's efforts to double down on him just amount for nothing.
Yeah, second Rift Herald here. This tower looks toast. No one here to defend it. Rift Herald's a good enough minion. As Finn is
unrelenting.
Yeah.
But that's an inhib turret.
Yeah, so is RMT. That's the big problem here. As Ray's just going to be shooting the turret. Is that gone? That's so close, but no, not once again. The box was used. Revenge busy taking the Raptors, but again, it's more about zoning them off this upcoming objective. IMT did get the wave pushed out first, but CLG should be able to meet this one pretty early as Destiny is going to get TP'd on. He's got no health left, and IMT have to rally for the fight here. Poe Belter is the one to join in. Finn going to be targeted up by Revenge, who doing a decent amount of damage to Dragon now. He's going to go over. Destiny misses the hook and somehow still lives. And now Revenge, he's found one under Finn. Brox is going to take out Destiny, but here comes Revenge.
Oh, Poe Belcher couldn't find the kick, though. He's still in the back, and IMT just get the dragon and route them, and now have Pryo in the mid lane as well. This is a big advantage for IMT. They took down Finn, so they're really not scared of the rest.
Poe Belcher looking for the kick. Finds it, but not onto Raze. Revenge is going to be the target, but Raze still untouched. Rocket's going to go wide, though, and now CLG can keep changing.
Very nice Scry's plant there. They're going to see, but is there even enough? That's not a jungler. It is a Lee Sin. For the GP ult, he's going to give him a little bit more. Insanity, they're trying to buff the shockwave through. Poe Belcher going to be picked up here. It's so low, but Xerxe does find the smite, but Orianna's going to die as well. But Raze, we're going to pop off here as the follow-up is not there, but Finn with a great flank. Maybe going to shut off all the barons. Indeed, they will. CLG.
Almost back up. So maybe he can make some of that magic happen here, but with the Baron that IMT did get, a Revenge is still holding on to the single buff. Going to be enough to break this top and hip tower that they already did a lot of work on earlier. Now ulti's out from both Gangplank and Ezreal. They don't quite land on enough as Ray's going to have to dodge those Swirl Seeds, but does dodge that first one.
Committing the GPO to defend the large wave that was built up, but with the second one, IMT should be looking for it again. Poe Belcher's now looking for a flank as he still has kick.
And again, IMT can easily take this inhibitor. Raze has more than enough range. They've got the Baron. They're really going to cut them off here. Poe Belcher's got nowhere to go. Only can make it to Destiny. He's going to get himself flanked. Shockwave's not good enough, but of course, Destiny is good for the hook as Raze gets yet another kill.
Good poke, but you got a single member and a lantern to bail him out. The fight's still going, though. Sleep comes. Oh, it's not going to come out.
Yeah, not going to make it there. Not maybe enough priority targets. Boxer does have it, but maybe going to have to save it for the next one. But this Infernal Sword, they have to contest here. Finn getting chunked, IMT not all that healthy, but just gonna be patient here. Leash the Dragon out to the other side. GP ulti, tags Insanity, Raze gonna go drowsy. Turtle gonna get blocked up there by Destiny. Xerxes found the Dragon, Infernal Soul. Now over to Immortals and CLG. Just can't get anything here. Xerxes just cancel the max, in he goes. Xerxes having some fun as that's Insanity going in. Raze though pulled into the team fight. Two people are going to finish the game while Immortals win the rest of the team fight. Turtle explodes. Poor Insanity. So the game isn't going to end. But what's happening on the other side of the map? Observers, get me back over there. The next target is Raze. We'll get the double. But here comes POB. Ooh. Oh, the kick straight to the dome. Executes poor Jinx. And Xerxe now going to be chased down as well. Can they run down the bear?
I think he can. Just hit the Q.
Do you want to outrun the bear?
Oh, he missed it!
Yeah, Xerxe is okay. Good little dodge there. His Revenge is coming down
last
as well.
Time.
Yeah, IMT trying to bait them in. GP ulti may have to be committed here. One Scry's Bloom already gone. Not sure if they have any others. Ray's actually going to go to sleep, though. But they've already found POB. Ray's going to have to be careful here. Turtle, he shut him down. It's a Liliadot that actually finishes the kill. CLG still sticking in this game as Broxah going to buy time for the rest of the team. Poe Belcher finds the Q. Blast Plant. Top half of the map. They're getting one of these major buffs, winning a big team fight at Xerxe. Now Poe Belcher is looking to try and make a play. Destiny finds the hook. It's going to be common. It's deleted as Xerxe takes out Smoothie now.
Around the Baron, but this is not a serious threat. The Elder's already taken. They're going to make it to defend this, and CLG will now have to concede both objectives.
And now they run. It's a 5v4, and you don't have Elder. Oh my goodness. Turtle going to get himself executed. Viego finds him with the help of the Elder Dragon, and now Revenge is popping off with the reset. Gets this put to sleep by Broxah. The W is down, but Insanity's here to keep chasing his Revenge. No, it's Insanity that finds the Dragon Laser Beam that takes out the Liliana's Raze. This is his moment, finally his chance to go off on CLG. As it's only Smoothie left alive, and he died to start this sequence.
That's gonna be it. IMG struggles a little against CLG, but at the end of the day, the individual members just outplayed CLG. Destiny and Raze had a phenomenal showing here. This bot lane hard carried for IMG, and they'll also finish 3-0 this week.
There we go. The bot lane ace to finish it off, and to go along with the enemy Nexus, and everyone on Immortals should be proud. But the bot lane can take a bow, Crumbs, because they took over this game.
Ooh, the OC boys. What's in the water down there?